In this video, we will take a look at several of the viewing tools available to us in Autodesk Inventor. First, we will look at some ways to reorient our view. Here you can see I have a 3D part, and if you want to zoom in and out on your part, you just simply roll your mouse wheel down to zoom in and up to zoom out. Then, if you want to pan around, you press your mouse wheel down and move your mouse around. So you're basically performing a click and drag, but while pushing down the mouse wheel. In order to orbit, you can use that same pan function while holding the shift key at your keyboard. So hold the shift key, then press down the mouse wheel and move your mouse, and you'll be able to quickly orbit around your 3D part. We also have the view cube in the upper right corner of the graphics window, and next to the view cube, you'll see the home button. When I select the home button, it just takes me back to the default isometric view that I started with. It is possible to orbit the part by clicking and dragging on the view cube, but as you can see, it's a little more jumpy. I think if you're going to 3D orbit, the shift and the middle mouse wheel are your best bets. But the great advantage of the view cube is to be able to look directly at some of these specific faces. For example, I can click on the right face and look directly that direction. Or if I want a specific isometric view, I can click one of the corners of the cube to get it. If I want to look down from the top, I can click on the top, and I can use the arrows around the outside of the cube to rotate my view. And I can use these arrows to switch to the other sides as well. So lots of different ways that you can use the view cube to reorient your part. Here on the right, we have our navigation bar. And the first tool here on the navigation bar is the navigation wheel. This is another way that you can orbit around your 3D parts. I can click and drag on orbit, and you can see that it is doing the orbit without me having to hold the shift key. Again, it's important to note I'm not using the middle mouse button this time. I'm using the regular left mouse button. I can also use the pan option here. And I can also click and drag to zoom. So I think you'll agree that to orbit, zoom, and pan, it's much faster to use your mouse wheel. However, if you find yourself maybe on a laptop and you don't have a mouse with a wheel, this is certainly an option to get you through. There are some additional features here on the navigation wheel that we will look at in a future lesson. So for now, I'll go ahead and close it. Here we also have the pan tool. Again, just another way I can click and drag to pan. Then we have some zoom tools here. I can click the drop down and do a zoom all, for example, which will zoom to show everything. So if I'm zoomed way in or way out, I can select the zoom all and it will zoom to show me my entire part or assembly. You can also do this with your mouse wheel. If you're zoomed really far in or out, if you double click your mouse wheel, it will also perform a zoom all to zoom to show you everything on screen. Then we also have the orbit tool. So this is another way to do a 3D orbit around the part. Again, if you find yourself without a mouse with a wheel, these are some viable options to be able to navigate through your parts. The last button here is the one that you will probably find most useful. It is the look at tool. You'll also notice in the little screen tip that pops up here, you can use the keyboard shortcut of the page up button on your keyboard. The look at tool will allow me to click on a planar surface and look directly at it. So in some cases, I could pull this off with my view cube. I could have just selected the right side. But if you think about this angled surface in here, if I want to look directly at it, I don't have a face on the view cube that's associated to that, but I can use my look at tool to look directly at that angle. And again, I'll go ahead and click home to return back home. Next, let's take a look at some visual styles. I'm going to click on the View tab, and here in the Appearance panel, I've got the Visual Style dropdown. You can see I'm currently in Shaded. I have a Realistic mode, so if I'm using a specific type of material, that will appear here. I can use Shaded with Edges, where we can actually highlight the edges a little bit better there. I can do Shaded with Hidden Edges, and now you can see all of the hidden features inside this part. I can do a wireframe where I can completely see through the part. and I can do a wireframe with hidden edges. And I can do a wireframe with only visible edges. We also have a few more styles here, such as monochrome, watercolor, sketch illustration, and technical illustration. So several different styles there. I'm going to head back to shaded with edges, which is usually my preferred version. The last thing that we'll look at in terms of visibility is turning on the visibility of work features. For example, every part has three origin planes. In my model browser, I can expand the origin folder. Then I can right-click on one of these origin planes and select visibility to get them to show up on screen. This can be convenient if you want to sketch on this plane, for example. I can go ahead and turn on the visibility of the other two origin planes as well. And now you can see the three origin planes through the center of the part. I can go ahead and turn those off individually. I can also, up top here on the View tab, select Object Visibility and turn off either just the planes or all work features if I want. Then once more, I'll select Home to return back to my original view. To recap, if you want to zoom or pan or orbit, I recommend you use the wheel, roll up and down, press it down and move it around to pan, hold Shift and press it down to orbit, and double-click the wheel to do a zoom all. Then, of course, we could use the View Cube and the Home button as needed, and we can adjust our visual styles here on the View tab. That concludes this look at viewing tools in Autodesk Inventor.